So, six ARGB fans with a controller for less than $40. Are they worth it? Let's check them out, shall we? Okay, so these are the Okinos. These are case fans from Okinos. Now, sorry if I pronounced that completely wrong, but here's what comes in the box now. Modern tips, and then PWM for the pump fan. But what essentially is a pack of six ARGB infinity fans. So let's get them out of the box. Okay, essentially it's these fans by here, and there's six of them in a pack. So it's essentially a six pack of ARGB fans. Now, they are standard 4-pin PWM and standard ARGB, which is actually good, but these got like infinity mirrors on them. And as you can see, they're actually quite thick compared to normal fans. So yeah, now essentially you get all these six fans, and then of course then you get this beer, which has got the accessories. Now, as for the accessories, what comes in the box is you get the screws for it as well, and then you get this then, which is a installation guide. Yes, this does include a ARGB hub as well, and then it tells you how to control them. And that's essentially it. So yeah, and then you've obviously got then the ARGB hub. Now, considering that for the whole set of fans is about $35 to $40, it's an absolute bargain essentially in that price. So this is the ARGB hub right here with double-sided tape. Now, does that look like it's... Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Doesn't it look... Yeah, it does. Whoa. I don't think it's meant... Oh, yes, it is. Yes, it is. So it's got modes and LED speed. The standard ARGB and standard 4-pin. Oh, SATA. And then I've got this proprietary cable then, which is in the box by here, which is the connects to that. And then, of course, then it's standard connectors there. So, big thank you to them sending this out. So let's get to the specs. Okay, so as for the fans, now these are standard, like I said, ARGB as well as PWM, but these do have three types of different lighting effects. As of course that is with the included hub as well. Now, as for like the LEDs, there's 16 LEDs on both sides, so blah and blah, 16 LEDs. And then as for like the RPM, these are rated for between 800 and 1800 RPM. That's enabled by 4-pin PWM. The CFM isn't exactly the best one. It's only 52.4 CFM. That's not exactly something I would recommend for a radiator, but that's how we're going to review them. Now, as for the decibel rating, they are rating it for 29 decibel. That's as low, and then for the highest end they rate it for 30, but obviously they do say these are rated for 30,000 hours life expectancy with a hydro bearing. So that's what the bearing type's inside. So let's get these installed on an AIO and see if these can actually perform any good, shall we? Okay, so as for how I'm going to test the fans, now I am going to be using the MR360 from InWin because it's very simple to use. All it has is this with an ARGB, and then the pump is located up the top. So it's very easy to use, and there's no other wires involved. So I've picked the fans. These are the three I'm going to use. As a thermal paste, I will be using the Polymather X10. So this is a very good thermal paste. I've shown that in testing. It's up there with Thermal Grizzly as well as Thermal Right and Arctic. So that's going to be the thermal paste I use. So let's get the fans installed, and then we can start getting it into the system. Now, as for what screwdriver I'm going to use, I'm going to use this Arctic precision screwdriver kit. If you want to get one, I'll leave a link down below. Shameless plug, I know, but this is a fantastic little kit. and I really like it, especially the overall design. Look at it, just beautiful. So let's get these fans installed now, and we'll be back. And of course then that's where that is installed. Now of course these have infinity mirrors, so let's get this installed on the in the system, shall we? Okay, so this is 50% fan speed. I'm going to put my mic up towards the fans and pull away, and let's see how quiet they are. Dead silent. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. So yes, you can hear them at 100%, but they aren't the loudest fans I've ever heard. Now, as for the test bench being used, it is my AM4 platform, which is housed in the BeQuiet 800FX. The AIO used for testing was the MR360 from InWin. So, it's an AMD Ryzen 9 5900X, 16 gigs of DDR4 with an X570 platform, and it's got an RX 7600XT. Okay then, so if you are a fan of the channel, you will know that when it comes to my testing methods, I do include two different types of tests. That's 50% fan speed with and also 100% fan speed. That does also include the fans that are in the BeQuiet Shadowbase 800FX, which is four 140 light wing fans. So just so you guys know. Now before the testing started, I did range the ambient temperature in the room at 10 Celsius, but the room did heat up after both tests. It was at 14 Celsius. So as for 50% fan speed, the CPU power, just the highest it actually went was 201 watts, but the lows it did go down to 189 watts. Now as for the CPU clocks, the highs were 4.9 with a low of 4.2, but it's well above base clocks, you don't have to worry there. As for the Cinebench R23 run for 50% fan speed, the idles were 25 with a max of 75. Blender Pavilion, idles 25 with a max of 72. Blender Classroom, idles 25 with a max of 72. And 3D Mark Super Test, idles 25 with a max of 65 Celsius. Now, as for 100% fan speed, that does include the fans inside the case as well. The CPU power was only 1 watt actually higher for highs. It was 202 watts with a low of 186 watts. Now, the CPU clocks, this is where it becomes interesting, because the CPU clocks were actually 4.9 a high, but the low at 4.4. So we did actually increase the overall CPU clock by 200 megahertz, which is actually quite impressive. But how does the thermals actually look? Well, for the idles of Cinebench R23, they were 22 Celsius, and I did recheck that 3 times to double, to be 100% sure. The max was 73 with Blender Pavilion, the idles are 22 with a max of 70, and Blender Classroom, idles 22 with a max of 71. A little bit odd there, usually it's the other way around, but still. The 3D Mark Super Test, the idles were 22 with a max of 62. Okay then, so when it comes to these fans, yes, they look very similar to what Thermalright had, but the major difference would be the overall connector. The connector on this one isn't daisy chainable, so you wouldn't be able to daisy chain all three. That's where the included ARGB controller comes in. But there's one issue with that, is all of this. Is look at that. It's ridiculous, all that cable management. Yes, I understand it will be okay for normal users, but if you don't like clutter, then these aren't for you. But other than that, what I will say is the overall lighting does look very nice. I do like the RGB, the infinity mirror, that particular effect I am a fan of. Now, for the overall pricing, these are at $39.99, which, considering the price range and what you actually get, is actually a great deal. You're getting a lot for your money here with the included hub as well. So yeah, look, I hope you at least enjoyed the video. Make sure you check out my other fan reviews, because I've done quite a few of them. Not loads, but I'm starting to do more, and quite honestly these are within the range, and quite honestly the price is fantastic. So I think you should consider these, especially if you want all the same case fans to match them as well, which for $40, that's nothing these days for 6 ARGB fans with a hub. So yeah, look, I will try to find a link down below, because they are available in the US, and I will make sure to look for the links as well for over here in the UK. I hope you at least enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe. This is Richard from WELSHYTECH. I hope you guys have a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. Goodbye.